Hello everybody, this is Mojo from ThreeChordGuitar.com. As I'm filming this, it's January 1st, 2008. So, since I probably won't have a chance to say that to you in person, here we go. Have a wonderful 2008 year. Outside, it's snowing right now and pretty hard. They're saying we're going to get 9 inches today. So, you know, every time they tell you you're going to get 9 inches, it sounds good. And then they say, well, it's 9 inches of snow. Like, okay, never mind that. All right. I received several requests for people who want to learn how to play Stairway to Heaven. And I know it's supposed to be a no Stairway to Heaven zone, although I kind of wonder where that came from. But anyway, I'll give it a shot and see what we can do together. I probably don't play it the way it's on the record, and it's probably overly simplified. The reason for that is because, well, I never actually saw the tabs. I just one day picked up my guitar and tried to remember what the song went like, and this is what I ended up with. So it may not be 100% accurate. It probably is not 100% accurate, but it might get you halfway there, or at least give you an idea. And that's the way I've been playing it ever since that day. So anyway, hopefully it's of some help to you. It starts with a bar chord on the 5th fret. So your index finger goes across the 5th fret, and your ring finger will go on the D string at the 7th fret. The other fingers are not touching anything. And you play the D string and the high E string at the same time using your thumb and whatever finger you want to use. I usually use my middle finger, my Johnny Cash finger. And it goes something like this. So then with my index, without moving anything on this hand, I just pluck the Mi, La, Re, Sol, so the G, B, and high E string, okay? So, we start it like this, and then we change, okay? The change in question involves your Johnny Cash finger going on the 6th fret on the D string, and your pinky going to the 7th fret on the high E string. So you went from this position, and then you go to this one where you lift the index finger and slide your pinky from the 7th fret to the 8th fret. So if you look at it, actually, all that really is you're descending on this string here. So Mi, La, Re on the D string, you're descending, going back towards this side of the headstock, while your pinky gradually goes up. So if you look at just this finger here, it kind of goes like this. So I went basically from 7th fret, 6th fret, and just a 5th fret, which is handled by the bar chord. Okay. As opposed to my pinky that went, okay, so it went nothing on the high E string because it was just bar here at the 5th, and then the pinky got on the 7th fret, and then the 8th. So that's all the motif is. Okay, and in between, my index finger either plucks going up or going down. That's all there is. Then we finally get out of this bar chord position and get to a D chord. Then we go to this interesting chord. It kind of looks like a C chord, but it's really not a C chord. In this chord, I have my index finger on the 1st fret of the B string, have my Johnny Cash finger on the 2nd fret of the Mi, La, Re, Sol, G string, and I have my ring finger on the 3rd fret of the D string, and I just pluck it. Note that at the end, my index finger will pluck the open E string with nothing on, nothing fretted. Then I go to a G chord and A minor. And that's the first part of the song. And you can do this thing that they do. I usually don't do it myself, but basically it's on the A string. You just plug the A string with nothing on, and then you slide your usually ring finger to the 8th fret, then down one to the 7th, and then you start again the same motif. Alright, that gets us to the second part, which goes like this. So we start with the on the A string. We're going to be fretting with whatever finger you want. I usually start with nothing in the A, then the Johnny Cash finger on the second fret, and then the ring finger on the third, because that gets me ready to set up a C chord, which is what I'm going to need next. Okay? So once I'm in the C, what I fret, or what I pluck, pardon me, with my right hand is the D chord, the G chord, and then the E chord. Then I go to a D chord. And then, I don't remember. Let's try it. Now that same chord I just mentioned earlier on, that looks like a C chord, but it's really not. So once again, I got my index finger at the first fret of the B string, my Johnny Cash finger at the second fret of the G string, and my ring finger at the third fret of the D string. And I go back to an A minor from there. And then do the same thing. C chord, G chord. And then I do a D chord. At first I do a D chord without the Johnny Cash finger. And I just strum it down. And then do a hammer-on, so that I get back to a D chord. A minor, C, G, and a D chord. Once you're done doing that, you basically go back. So that's the finger picking part. Between that and the harder part, there is this thing. Look at that. What that is a regular D chord, again without this guy, without the Johnny Cash finger. And so I go, down, put the Johnny Cash finger back on, and then strum up with my thumb, and then do a D sus 4, which is a regular D chord, except that I add my pinky to the third fret of the high E, and I strum it down. Lift it up, and I go back to a C. And when I go to this part, I basically put my pinky here on the third fret of the high E string. Off, on. Alright, the last part you need to know is the descending riff that goes. Okay, this is an F chord. If you slide your F chord to the 3rd fret, you basically get a G chord. Now slide it up again to the 5th fret and lift your Johnny Cash finger. And that's the chord where you start. Then slide it down to a G, F, back to G, back to that chord, G, and she's buying a Stairway to Heaven, baby. This is it. This is the song. I hope this was helpful to you. If you have any questions, we have our forum at ThreeChordGuitar.com. I'd love to help you out. Take care and Happy New Year.